when to use which SARS-CoV-2 diagnostic test. Coronavirus disease 2019, or COVID-19, is currently keeping the whole world in suspense. The pathogen that causes the disease is called Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome, Coronavirus 2, or SARS-CoV-2 for short, and belongs to the family of coronaviruses. These coronaviruses are not new and have caused headlines several times in recent years. A SARS epidemic already affected the world in 2002 and 2003. In addition, in 2012, the Arabian Peninsula in particular was hit by MERS-CoV. It's interesting to note that not all coronaviruses are equally dangerous. There are four less harmful variants, for example, which cause coughs, colds, and hoarseness every year. So why is SARS-CoV-2 having a major impact? Because the pathogen is new. This means that our immune system is not familiar with this virus and therefore cannot defend itself optimally. In order to survive, a virus must replicate itself. It cannot do this on its own and requires host cells to reproduce. The coronavirus docks itself to the host cell using a special protein called the spike protein that favors receptors on the surface of lung cells. Once the spike protein is docked to the lung cells, the way into the host cell is open. The virus enters the cell and immediately begins to release its RNA and four characteristic viral proteins into the cell. This kicks off the process of reprogramming the cell. And this means that the virus takes over the host cell's replication and protein biosynthesis systems. Subsequently, the cell starts to produce large amounts of viral RNA and other viral proteins. Once these components are correctly assembled within the host cell, the result is the creation of many identical copies of the virus. The host cell often dies in this process. As a result, the newly formed viruses are released and can infect other cells. After a host cell produces many new virus copies, more replication cycles occur. For patients, this means that severe complications can arise, as lung cells in particular are attacked and die. This may cause damage to the lungs, which could affect their function. This is where the name SARS comes from, Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome, and why so many patients require ventilators in intensive care units. In diagnostic research, we do everything we can to detect the virus quickly and reliably using specific and sensitive diagnostic methods. One diagnostic method to detect SARS-CoV-2, the virus that causes COVID-19, is called reverse transcription polymerase chain reaction, or RT-PCR test. This technology detects, for example, the virus RNA and is very sensitive. Therefore, it's ideally suited for detecting patients that are currently infected with SARS-CoV-2 and may be infectious to others at this stage. If the patients already have symptoms, this test is particularly accurate. With this test procedure, acute SARS-CoV-2 infections are now detected worldwide. An antigen test can also be used to identify patients currently infected with SARS-CoV-2. This is done by examining whether viral proteins are present in the throat or nasal fluid. These tests can detect four main coronavirus proteins: the spike protein, which we have already introduced, the membrane protein, an envelope protein, and the fourth is a nucleocapsid in which the RNA is embedded. As the disease progresses over time and the virus is cleared from the body by our immune system, it becomes more difficult to detect the viral RNA and viral proteins through RT-PCR and antigen tests, respectively. However, our body's immune system reaction to the virus can be measured further. The antibodies produced specifically to fight against SARS-CoV-2 can be detected with an immunoassay, also known as an antibody test. Why are immunoassay tests so important? Reliable immunoassay tests can help identify individuals who have already been infected with SARS-CoV-2 but who may not have been diagnosed at the time. As suggested in studies with other coronaviruses, this could mean that antibody test positive individuals have gained immunity or reinfection may not be as severe as the primary one. This immune individual could go back to work, for example, and not endanger themselves or others. If further research confirms that recovering from COVID-19 signifies immunity, this test will also be a valuable tool in vaccine development to show that the vaccine elicits an effective immune response in those that receive it. Furthermore, it could help identify the individuals who have not already had COVID-19, making them a priority for vaccination. Once 60 to 70% of a population is immune, it becomes increasingly difficult for the virus to spread. During a pandemic such as COVID-19, reliable diagnostic tests that target both infected and recovered patients are needed to help combat the virus. They help us to determine the extent of an outbreak and important disease characteristics, such as the proportion of asymptomatic carriers of the virus in a population and whether immunity is sustained. Importantly, diagnostic testing is essential to evaluate the effectiveness of prevention, treatment, and population-wide containment measures.